Hello students, in today's session we will study the first chapter of history, the rise of nationalism in Europe. What is nationalism? Look the word nationalism. If we divide the word into two, we get national and ism. What is ism? Ism means system. So nationalism is a system of a nation. In simple language, we can define nationalism. It is a feeling of one's own nation. It is a way of thinking that says that some groups of human, such as ethnic groups, should be free to rule themselves. What is a nation? A nation may be a community having a common homeland, a common culture, and common tradition, that is nation. Now let us see, how did nationalism emerge in Europe? European nationalism, in its modern sense, was born out of the desire of a community to assert its unity and independency. In the 19th century, there began a determined struggle to realize nationalist aspirations. The French Revolution had inspired people all over the Europe. It spread the ideas of liberty, equality, and fraternity. It generated the spirit of nationalism. Napoleon, you know, though he established a monarchy in France, carried forward the revolutionary ideas of equality and nationalism. Napoleon's empire gave to Europe a form of unity, even though it was imposed by him through conquest. Napoleon established his empire through conquest, but that was established a form of unity. A new concept emerged which bound people together with a sense of belonging and unity. A sense of unity and belonging that bounded people together. Nationalism began to be formed by those who shared a common tradition and a common territory. Now let us see how a French artist, Frédéric Soriou, visualized his dream of a world. See the picture. In 1848, Frédéric Soriou, a French artist, prepared a series of four prints visualizing his dream of a world made up of democratic and social republics. The first print of the series shows the people of Europe and America, men and women of all ages and social classes, marching in a long train and offering homage to the Statue of Liberty, you know, Statue of Liberty in New York. And, you know, the artist of the time of the French Revolution personified liberty as a female figure. They gave the image of liberty as a female figure. We can see the torch of enlightenment. She bears in one hand, who bears? The Statue of Liberty. On one hand of the Statue of Liberty, we can see the torch of enlightenment. What do you mean by enlightenment? Means it is the action of enlightening or the state of being enlightened. It is awakening or getting rid of one's own darkness. It is also called self-realization.
enlightenment means self realization, and on other hand she bears the charter of the rights of man in the other hand. The charter of the rights of man, what do you mean by charter of the rights? Charter of the rights means bill of rights. It is also called declaration of rights, means it is a list of the most important rights to the citizens of a country. And on the foreground means in front of the Statue of Liberty, the image lie the shattered remains of the symbols of absolutist institutions. What do you mean by absolutist? Absolutist means government or system of rule that has no restraints, no control on the power. That is monarchical government. Yes, in front of the image of Statue of Liberty, we can see the shattered remains, broken remains of absolutist institutions, means remains of monarchical government. In Soros' utopian vision, the people of the world are grouped as distinct nations, identified through their flags and national costume. In Soros' vision, the people of the world are marching in front of the Statue of Liberty and they are identified with their flags and national costume. Leading the procession, this procession was led by United States, Switzerland. Already these countries became nation state. And it was followed by France. In front we can see France. It was identified by its revolutionary tricolor. And after that Germany. Germany was followed by people of Austria, the Kingdom of Two Sicilies, Lombardy, Poland, England, Ireland, Hungary and Russia. All these countries were marching in front of the Statue of Liberty. This chapter will deal with many of the issues visualized by Soros. The end result of these changes was the emergence of the nation state in place of the multinational dynastic empires of Europe. This chapter will look at the diverse processes through which nation states and nationalism came into being in 19th century Europe. Next, the topic is the French Revolution and the idea of a nation. Yes, you know French Revolution, that gave the world liberty, equality and fraternity, which transferred power from monarchy to active citizens. There was a political transformation took place in France, which spread from France to other parts of Europe. The first clear expression of nationalism came with the French Revolution in 1789. The political and constitutional changes that came in the wake of the French Revolution led to the transfer of sovereignty, supreme power, from the monarchy to a body of the French citizens. Here, sovereignty, power, supreme power, transferred from monarchy to the body of French citizens. The French revolutionaries introduced various measures and practices that could create a sense of collective identity amongst the French people.
Now let us see what were the measures and the practices they introduced to create a uniform identity amongst its people. First is that the ideas of La Patrie. La Patrie means the fatherland, and Les Citoyens. Les Citoyens means the citizen. Emphasized the notion of a united community enjoying equal rights under our constitution. First of all, they introduced the idea of La Patrie and Les Citoyens, that is common to all. Second thing is that a new French flag, the tricolor, was chosen to replace the former royal standard. A new French flag was introduced. The estate general, you know, there were three estates. The society was divided into three estates, three groups: first estate, second estate, and third estate. The estates general was elected by the body of active citizens, and it was renamed the National Assembly. Next point is that the new hymns were composed. What do you mean by hymns? Religious song. Oaths taken, martyrs commemorated. Commemorated means remembered. All in the name of the nation. Hymns were composed, oaths were taken, martyrs were commemorated, all were in the name of the nation. Nation addressed all these things. A centralized administrative system was put in place, and it formulated uniform laws for all citizens within its territory. Means centralized administration. There was no division of power. Administration was centralized in one hand, and it formulated uniform laws. One law for all the people. One law, one nation. Uniform law for all citizens were introduced. Next, internal customs duties and dues were abolished, and a uniform system of weights and measures was adopted. There was no internal customs duties or dues. Only one tax will be there, and a uniform system of weights and measures. There was no different measures of weights and measures introduced at different places as early they practiced, but there is no different system of weights and measures now. A uniform system of weights and measures was adopted. Regional dialects were discouraged, and French was spoken and written in France. Means a common language. One national language was introduced, that is French, and it became the common language of the nation. All these were the measures adopted by the revolutionaries to introduce a common identity amongst the French people. The revolutionaries further declared that it was the mission and the destiny of the French nation to liberate the people of Europe from despotism. What is despotism? That is dictatorship. So the revolutionaries, they declared that all these measures they adopted, and they created all these things, and it was declared that it is the destiny of the French nation to liberate the people of Europe from dictatorship, from despotism. That's all for today. The session is over here.